Greetings everyone, my name is Mudita Bansal. I am from DAV Public School, Sector 14, Faridabad. I am here to present famous organization Google, who has paved its way from anonymity to fame. Google, a famous organization who had faced many problems during their startup. It was not easy for Google to start the company and provide information to the World Wide Web. Google's story began in the summers of 1995 at Stanford University when Sergey Brin met Larry Page. Sergey Brin was a second-year grad student in the computer science department at Stanford University, California. During this time, Brin was still deciding whether to attend Stanford for grad school. Larry Page, who was an engineering major, ended up in Brin's group. During this time, a lot of Stanford alumni were making millions through internet companies. But for Page, it was just the start of his quest. During this time, Page wasn't looking for a better way to search the web. Page always liked to stick with the basics. The reason for his quest was neither money nor a successful business model, but a genuine interest in the web for its mathematical characteristics. During the time of his research, he came up with many conclusions. He found out that it was insignificant to follow links from one page to another. He discovered that it was important to find pages which were linking back to the website and find such backlinks, a project which he called Backrub. There were a lot of obstacles which he had to face during his journey. One problem led to another, but it didn't stop Page from introducing the ultimate search engine of the 21st century. At the time of Backrub, there were an estimated 10 billion documents and a massive number of links among them. The computing resource to crawl such a massive number of websites were far beyond his reach at that time. After a lot of brainstorming, Page finally started building out his crawlers. Seeing the complexity and the challenges of the idea by Sergey Brin to the job, Page had Brin to help him to get through all the mathematical complexities which they were facing during that time. Page and Brin started working from a dorm room on a search engine that used links to determine the importance of individual pages on the World Wide Web. Furthermore, they created a ranking system that would recompense important source links and penalize the links which did not come from the sources. Page and Brin came up with an algorithm dubbed PageRank. With this new algorithm, they were able to calculate the number of links to a particular website and the number of links into each of the linking websites, almost similar to Cartesian counting approach. With a major breakthrough, Page and Brin, as they were able to list more popular websites to the top of their list and less popular website at the end of their list. With this major breakthrough, they realized that their data can have implications for internet search. With Backrub, which almost worked like a search engine as it gave the list of backlinks, and their ranking algorithm, they were also able to sort these links by importance. Page and Brin released the first version of Google on the Stanford website in August 1996. After its release, Google became an instant hit inside Stanford. Inspired by the initial success of their search engine, Brin and Page began to upgrade their services. This was the beginning of their extraordinary journey when they discovered the tremendous power of their search engine. Here are some achievements of Google. AdSense. This revolutionary self-service ad platform for websites was launched in 2003 and opened up a whole new playing field for online advertising. AdSense is now Google's main revenue generator, accounting for 30% of the search giant revenue. YouTube. Google acquired the video platform in 2006 for $1.65 billion. Today, the platform enjoys 3 billion ad impressions a week. Google Maps. When released, it simply kicked MapQuest out of the water. Now it's everywhere, and Google's location mapping boasts more initiative features like 3D views, Google Latitude, Google Places, and most recently Google Hotpot Food and Entertainment Recommendations. Gmail. Gmail is not just a popular email service for Google, it's the launchpad for many other services like Google Account, App, GChat, Voice Call, Documents, and many more. 20% time. This allows the employees to work on the side projects by giving their 20% time. These side projects have resulted in products like Google Wave, Google News, and Google Reader. Companies looking to be the best are costs here. Android. Google acquired Android in 2005 and in 2007 announced it was the company's official smartphone platform. Verizon Partner. The Motorola Droid launched in 2009 was in fact the second Android device to hit the market, but it set the stage for Android popularity. It was thanks to Google's deal with Verizon to market Droid. Business model of Google. Google generated about $21 billion in revenue last year. The vast majority of that revenue, well over 95%, comes from advertising via its search engine as its AdSense program, which places ads on millions of websites. The current predominant business model for commercial search engine is advertising. Google search engine has ranked number one in the Alexa index, proving itself to be the leader in search engine usage. This can also be noted that Google has become synonymous with web search. Often you will hear how people would Google the information rather than search for it. The other side of the Google's usually successful business plan is innovation. Here are some technology behind the brand. Google search technology is reliant upon computer algorithms to determine search position. PageRank, the technology that determines the importance of each page. It considers 500 million variable and 2 billion terms to determine how a page will rank in the search engine. Hypertext matching analysis, the technology that analyzes page context and ensures the results returned are relevant to the query entered into the search engine. The technology that Google uses to underpin its data centers are of utmost importance in ensuring Google has the scale, speed, and efficiency to serve its rapid growing number of users. Google believes relevant advertising can be used as search results, other forms of content. In combination with AdSense, Google developed the AdWords for advertisers who want to reach a qualified audience as efficiently as possible. Acquisitions of Google. Google's famous 20% time allowing employees to take one day a week for some blue sky thinking on original project has produced some innovations such as Google News and the virtual reality Google Cardboard fold-out viewers. But that wasn't enough for Google's founder. Over the last few years, they have been an spending spree bringing dozens of companies under the Google, now Alphabet, umbrella. Google's executives are driven by wanting to have startups. They want to have a portfolio of startups, says Mark Barron of online technology publication Recode. What made Google the best click hit? Google has extended itself over 50 countries. The new search engine adopted the name Google in 1997 and started a rapid growth trajectory that resulted in its first billion URL indexes by June 2000. By mid-1999, when Google received $25 million round of venture capital funding, it was processing 5 lakh queries per day. The search engine soon proved successful and the expanding company moved several times, finally settling at Mountain View in 2003. Activity began to explode in 2000 when Google became the client search engine for one of the web's most popular sites, Yahoo. By 2004, Yahoo dispensed with Google services. Users were searching on Google 200 million times a day. By May of 2011, Google grew to the most visited websites within the European Union with a reach of 94% of internet users. By June of 2012, Google gained almost 67% of the United States market share, making Google the most successful search engine in the world. What went wrong in the Google? Early in 1999, Brin and Page decided they wanted to sell Google to Excite. They went to Excite CEO George Bell and offered to sell it to him for $1 million. He rejected the offer. The model of selling keywords advertising was first pioneered by Goto.com, an idealable spin-off created by Bill Gross. When the company changed names to Overture Services, it sued Google over infringements of the company's pay-per-click and bidding patience. In early June 2020, a $5 million class action lawsuit was filed against Google by a group of people saying that Chrome's agnostic browsing mode still collects their user history. Google's potential concerns are the click fraud, which is the most significant influence on their profit investment. This generates an inappropriate option that leads to a pay-per-click ad. Conclusions of Google. Google is a mix of excellent marketing ideas, smart choices, great advisory, and culture of innovation, which make them a great provider of quality products and highlight them as promising performers showing wide variety in the market. Google was not the first device for searching or email or advertisement, but its market leadership was due to fact that it did all of those things better than others. So it can easily be estimated that the strategy which Google can easily follow is leading it towards the pinnacle of success and helping it to be the most established player in industry. We all want Google as a third part of our brain. Anything which we want to shop, search, listen, or watch is available at Google. Therefore, Google is known as the Google Baba.